Hi, this is episode 8 of How to Do Digital Marketing, where we help people learn and apply proven techniques of digital marketing in their business or in their professional life. This is episode 8, where we are going to touch upon content management systems. But before you listen to this, I would also advise you to watch episode 6 and episode 7, where we touch upon the basics fundamentals of website development process. This is in continuation to that, where we are going to talk about content management systems or CMS. For more information on digital marketing, to understand, to learn and to apply, please visit www.howtododigitalmarketing.com. So what is CMS? CMS, or a content management system, is a set of tools that help you manage digital information on the web. Today, most of the websites in the world are built using a content management system. And we'll look and see and understand why this is so and why is it so popular. But essentially, it helps to create and maintain content without the knowledge of programming. So you don't necessarily need to be a coder or a developer or a programmer to actually create and build websites today. You could make use of a CMS system and actually create a website in no time at all. And above all, it helps to build and manage the content that you have on a website far more effectively. Let's look at how did this whole thing evolve. Back in 2004, on the early days of the internet, most of the websites were actually built using HTML. They were HTML websites and they used HTML code, they used CSS. There were sites which are built in Flash also, although Flash is no longer the default system or applied much in building websites. But today, most of the websites are built with CMS platforms like WordPress. You would have heard this word. So WordPress is the world's largest and the most popular content management system. And why is it so helpful? Number one, it's very user friendly to build the websites. You don't need programming language. And instead of using HTML, it's a simple drag and drop or a simple matter of using templates to create your own website. The three key features of any CMS is, number one, you can design and create and maintain a personalized content for the website. Number two, it's an automated publishing process. And number three, you can actually, as a website owner, you can review and approve any content prior to publication. So you, as a website owner, are completely in control of what goes onto the website, what is published on the website. If people comment on the website, you can review the comments before you actually approve it. And it allows you the flexibility of actually creating and managing content. And today the world has moved to a dynamic content, which means that your content needs to keep changing itself depending on what the user are required or requiring for. And as a result of which, a CMS platform is a very dynamic platform. It allows you to change content without the need of hiring a developer or a programmer. But before we get into that, let's look at some of the other features of what a CMS platform actually provides you. Number one, there are a whole lot of thousands and thousands of standard templates that you could probably pick and choose. There are free templates and there are paid templates. You have templates based on the kind of business that you do. So if you want to create a website for, let's say, education business like mine, or you want to create a service business website, you would have templates which are available, which have been created by third-party people who worked on WordPress, and you can simply use that template to build your own website. So the template comes with nice graphics, the template comes with ready-made functionalities, the template comes with great images, and all you need to do is just simply take the template, replace the content, and hey presto, you have your own new website. That's not all. You also have a host of plugins. Now, we looked at in episode 6, we looked at what are the plugins. Plugins are essentially things that you can add on to your website to extend the functionality of it. So you can have plugins to create your own, or let's say to help you to do your SEO. There's a plugin called the Yoast SEO, which actually helps you to do your own on-page SEO far more effectively than what you would get if you were to hire an external SEO specialist. You also get regular software updates, so upgrades of the theme that you can use, that comes with workflow management. The CMS comes with collaboration tools And above all, it comes to document management, which means that you can manage the content. You can say this, publish this content, hide this content, remove this content, all in a matter of seconds by simply pressing a few buttons. All you need to do is understand which button to press. Some more features which are there, you could even set up content distribution and content updates by emails. You could display content in various languages. You have controlled access to the page, which means their website can only be accessed the back end of the website where you're actually managing this entire website. You can actually control the access to it so that only you or a few people that you trust can actually use this website. So there are two aspects of the content management system. One is the entire thing is the backend, where you actually control the entire dynamic website. And of course, then there's a front end, which is what the people or the user or your visitor gets to see when he comes and types www.xyzexample.com. Plus it's scalable, no matter whether your business is a one man business or a 1,000 people business, you could use a content management system to actually develop a great website. Plus, there are tools that allow you to easily edit, create drafts, and republish it at the time that is most suitable for you. The three most popular content management systems today in the world are WordPress, Drupal, and Joomla. WordPress accounts for almost 50%, or little more than 50% of the entire universe of websites that are built. Drupal is about 17%, and Joomla is a little less than 7%. So these three content management systems together actually account for almost 70% of the entire websites that are built today on the internet. So that's how popular content management systems have become today in 2017. And as if you're building a new website, it is likely that if you outsourced it, your web developer or your web agency is going to be using a CMS system. So if you're outsourced it, please understand from your web agency, what is the CMS platform that he's using? My recommendation is that if you're a small business, you should use WordPress, and because that's easy and even you can handle it at a later stage. If it's a complex business and we look at and see what kind of businesses should use WordPress, what kind of businesses should use Drupal or a Joomla. But the bottom line is that if you're building a website, please only consider using a CMS system. So let's look at why should we use WordPress versus other website builders. I've been recommending WordPress because primarily of four reasons. Number one, WordPress is free. That's not to say that it's 100% free, but yes, technically it is free. You have free templates. It's an open source platform. You can simply download it and also download a free template, and you can build your website by scratch by yourself without involving any programmer or any developer. Number two, it's very, very, very beginner friendly. Most of the blogs that you see, most of the publishing that you see are all on WordPress. Number four, whether your business, as I mentioned, is one man business or a 1,000 people business, WordPress is a great platform to use. And lastly, and the most important aspect, most of the templates, I would say almost all the templates that you get to see on WordPress, they're all automatically mobile responsive. And we looked at this in episode 6, the importance of making your website responsive across all devices, which is very critical. You don't need to have a programmer making it the site responsive. Your template is automatically responsive. So therefore, if you're building a website on CMS platform or a WordPress CMS platform, your website is automatically responsive and will scale itself up or down depending on the size of the device in which the user is actually viewing this website of yours. There are, of course, like I mentioned, the other platforms too. There's Drupal, which is a very, very powerful platform. And if you're an experienced coder, it's very, very popular because it allows you the flexibility to create a lot many more functions which WordPress doesn't allow you to. But on the other hand, it comes with a very steep learning curve. You really need to learn how to use Drupal. It is not easy. I would not recommend it if you're a beginner. I would not recommend it if you're not a developer yourself. Joomla is another platform, very popular. It is very similar to WordPress, but it requires a little bit of coding skills. to make it work. So if you understand programming, if you understand a bit of language, then I would suggest you can use a Joomla. If you are an experienced coder, then please use Drupal. But if you're a beginner, like I am a beginner, I am not a technology guy. I don't understand languages. I just understand technology, understand digital marketing, and I find using WordPress extremely comfortable to use. Let's look at if you're using a CMS versus not using a CMS, how do you build a website, or what should you be looking at when building a website? There are couple of fundamental principles that you need to bear in mind. Number one, when it comes to security, using a programming language like PHP is far better than using a CMS platform. Because security today is the biggest concern of all online businesses. So if you're using a CMS platform, the chances of your site getting hacked is much, much larger than if you are not using a CMS platform. Most CMSs are open source, and therefore everybody, the code base is open for everyone. Everyone knows what the code of the website is. And so therefore hacking is far more easier. Websites using PHP frameworks are more secure since they use a custom code. And therefore, if your business security is paramount, then I would not suggest you using a CMS platform. Number two, if it comes to flexibility, PHP is far ahead of CMS, because with PHP, you can integrate with third-party applications or third-party APIs, and operations are independent of each other's. CMS sites, the applications are not very flexible unless you're building a site with, let's say, with a Drupal, and you have to keep using plugins and modules within the CMS. And as a result of it, the site may tend to get a little bit heavy. And you would also need, the more plugins that you use, the more modules that you build within a CMS platform, it requires a lot of custom development, which brings it back to the fact that you will need a developer to actually build the website. Number three is that in terms of regards to upgrades, whether you have to choose a CMS or a PHP platforms, it all depends on your preference or your business. Upgrades help you in ensuring website security, and CMS has updates almost every single month or every couple of months. You will get an update saying that, hey, there's a new upgrade to the theme that you just bought or the theme that you just downloaded. Websites will continue to function without updates. Just to remind you, you not necessarily that you have to update your theme. It'll continue running functionally, but it essentially would not be as secure or as user-friendly as a new update. So I would suggest that if you're using a CMS platform and you get an upgrade notification, please use the upgraded version of the theme or the template that you have downloaded. Most of the PHP frameworks have updates, but not every month. Number four is that in terms of user experience, there's nothing to beat a CMS platform, because CMSs have been built keeping the website manager in mind, keeping the user in mind. And most of them already come ready-made with the responsive themes, so that any module or plugin placed with a website functions well on a mobile device, functions well on a tablet, and functions well on any device, no matter what the size or the screen of the device is. Another disadvantage of a PHP framework is that it does not have default standard user interfaces, which means that you really need to spend a lot of time, effort, and money in creating a UI, a UX design, which, as we saw, is a very, very critical important or a component when you're building a website, the UI and UX. All CMS platforms, the themes that you get are all designed extremely well. They're a delight to see. People love to see the themes, and you will be actually wowed if you're a beginner or building your own website with the kind of theme possibilities that you have with using WordPress or a Joomla or a Drupal. So before we get into what kind of CMS platform, so that was the four main reasons to look at exploring whether you have to use a PHP or a CMS platform. But the bottom line is that I would say that if you're building a website for the first time, if you're a small business owner, please stick to WordPress. If you're a large business, please consider using a Drupal or a Joomla. If you're looking at an e-commerce business, then a WordPress may not be as great as using maybe a Drupal or a Joomla. So it all depends on the business that you are in and the size of a business. So if you're building a a normal common basic corporate site, you could great way blindly choose to use WordPress. But however, if you're building a great functionally dependent with heavy features and heavy functionality, a WordPress site or a Drupal site may not be useful. You might have to look at a PHP framework to actually build your site. But now moving forward, let's understand which CMS platform would be best for your business need. So if first point is that if you're having a goods or services sell on a site, Joomla is great for its e-commerce capability. So if you're trying to run an e-commerce enabled platform or e-commerce enabled site, you might want to consider using Joomla. If you're looking at supporting multiple sites through the same CMS installation, then WordPress and Joomla's are great for supporting multiple sites within the same CMS installation. If your site is collecting sensitive data, which means that you have a lot of database led work, the CMS platforms are great because you can maintain your software and updated software. If you're looking at developing a community platform for users or for employees, Drupal is well touted and seems to be an ideal platform for making community-based websites. Let's look at each of these three CMS platforms that we have explored: WordPress, Drupal, and Joomla. And let's look at what are the primary benefits of each option. So WordPress, as I mentioned, is the most popular CMS and has the largest support community, which means that if you run into any problem, there are enough people out there who can actually help you solve your problem. So you really have no dearth of experts, no dearth of advice, which is there out there. Secondly, it has a maximum number of plugins and themes. There are hundreds and thousands of themes you just go to. So Envato is a place, or Theme Forest is a place where you could go to. You just type in the kind of business you're in and it'll show you a plethora of themes that you could simply download for free, or you need to buy it. Even if you want to buy a theme, it's not very expensive. Starting themes are from about $40 to $59, and it's a one-time license fee, so you really don't need to pay annually. So it's hardly about $59, so it's about 3,500 rupees in Indian currency. It's got easy to use interfaces. Anybody, and I mean anybody, with a little bit of patience can learn how to use WordPress. And in one of our episodes, we will be covering how to actually use WordPress as a platform. We will take you through a step-by-step guide in using WordPress. No matter, again, what size of business you are, whether it's a one-page website, whether it's a 10-page website, or even if it's a 100-page website, you can use WordPress. In fact, howtododigitalmarketing.com, that is a platform that we run, is built completely on WordPress. So you have videos there, you have articles there, you have guides there, you have a whole lot of stuff, a whole lot of functionality, all of which has been built on WordPress. But it has very limited development options. So as your site becomes more and more complex, you will discover that you will need the help of a developer or a coder to actually start creating custom-led applications, because you really need that kind of features in your website, that kind of functionality website. You might need to have a developer or coder, which you can get on a freelance, or you can hire one. Drupal is another great CMS platform. It's very powerful, very flexible. You have, again, like WordPress, you have thousands of add-on modules. So depending on what you want to add on, you want to add on a form, you want to add on an autoresponder, you want to add on an SEO plugin, you want to add on e-commerce functionality, you want to add on shopping cart functionality, you have add-ons available for all CMS platforms. If you're looking at complex sites with multiple users, you could look at Drupal as a community platform and a community CMS. But the con of Drupal is that if you do not know programming, you are best staying away from Drupal. So you need to be a programmer, you need to understand programming languages to actually start using Drupal. Joomla is the last of the three things that we are evaluating today. It's got an easy-to-use interface than Drupal. So in terms of easy-to-use interfaces, you have WordPress, which is the most easy interface to use. Then you have Joomla. And lastly, you have Drupal in terms of easy-to-use interface. It offers more flexibility than WordPress, but it actually is also a little bit of programming language that you need to know. It's if you're looking at e-commerce or social networking, is your kind of business that you're looking at, then I would suggest that you use Joomla instead of WordPress or a Drupal. And remember, all three of them are free to download. You can download it and use it. There are themes that you can buy. There are themes that you can download for free. Each of them have a support community. Each of them have thousands of people who are experts on this. Of course, WordPress has a largest support community and the largest base, because as you can see, almost 50% of the websites today are being built on WordPress. So that means there's a whole lot of people out there who actually understand and have gone through the same problems that you're likely to go through when you use any new tool for the first time. So gentlemen, ladies, that brings us to the last part of this particular episode 8, where we talk about content management system. I hope you have liked this presentation. I hope you have liked this video. You could find more resources, tips, guides, coaching programs, as well as courses on our website, which is, I'll repeat again, www.howtododigitalmarketing.com. If you've liked this video, please do share it with your friends. Please do subscribe to our channel. We would love our community to actually help us reach to more people from whom we can benefit by learning and getting these free videos that we are creating. Thank you very much and have a good day.